My name is Kate, and I'm 13 years old. I've been a gymnast for 7 or 8 years now. I've been on the competitive team for, I think, 5 years now, and I love it.
Dad took Kate to the doctor because she wasn't feeling good. She'd had a number of infections. She was spending 22 hours a week at the gym, so she had bruising, but she's always had bruises, so we didn't think anything of that. So late that afternoon, we got a call to come in for the test results, and we never would have guessed that it was leukemia, of all things. Kate and I ended up living in the hospital for 6 months. We came home for a couple weeks, twice during that time. Dad was home with the other two kids during the week. And then every other weekend, he'd come up and we'd switch spots for a day so I could run home and, you know, do some laundry and run some errands, you know, and just get out of the hospital. But poor Kate was stuck there the whole time. It's tough. Tough thing to have a kid with cancer.
One morning, little Hunter woke up with looked like a cold, snotty nose, and you know, sneezing, coughing, and by midday he was sick, and so Mom called the pediatrician, and he says bring him in. By 2:30 or 3 o'clock, Mom took him to urgent care. He was hurt. Young Ukrainian doctor there said it's RSV improved. But he had a heart rate that was 240 something. They sent him by ambulance over to the little trauma center. By 5 o'clock, Mom and Hunter were on their way to a pediatric intensive care unit. So we were there a week, and we got to a point where there were chaplains and, you know, just discussions you just wouldn't think you'd ever hear. Even simple questions like, my baby gonna be okay? I was coming through this atrium of the bottom floor of this hospital, and it's a beautiful place. The place, it was just packed with people, and all of a sudden it just went silent. You just noticed everyone was looking, and what it was a procession of these wagons. I saw them coming, and they had three kids, two and one, and they all had these cardboard kind of things that were holding them up, and they were kind of taped and pillowed into sitting upright. Had IVs going, tubes in the chest, tubes in the neck, tubes in the arms. And there wasn't a reaction that I didn't feel in just a millisecond or two. I mean, it took my legs out from under me. It was so shocking and so horrific. My first real salient, cogent thought was, the whole world needs to see this.
Even though this was such a horrible thing that happened, I've gotten to do a lot of things that I would have never gotten to do had this not happened.
She's not special because she doesn't have a leg. She's special because she's got a big heart and a big motor, and she'll do anything.